What ails India's data economy? Data is new currency in the current world because many of our transactions are deals with the data. Now we'll see the drawing parallels between the existing taxation systems and data structures. Similar to taxation systems in India, the data taxations or data structures has also been evolved, and we'll see the comparison between the two, and this thus help us understand the how data is being monetized by the government and the private firms. But the lack of robust data protection architecture in India raises serious concerns. We'll see the everything of such cause. In modern economy, taxes are collected from the individuals and organizations and are used as public expenditures. And similarly, in the parliamentary democracy, various kinds of taxations are available, like from individuals, from commercials, etc. And the overall revenue statement is called the budget. That before that, what are the policies to be implemented that are dealt with in the economic survey released annually ahead of the budget presentations. So in 2020, economic survey has hinted at a state attempt to monetize the personal data, essentially making the data as a commodity, because data is itself a commodity. And because the economic survey has specially mentioned that state attempt to monetize the personal data, essentially making the data as a commodity. Subsequently, in reply to the question in the parliament, the government has informed that the vehicle data in the country has been monetized around 655 crore, while the data monetization by the government at a time where there is no crystallized data protection architecture in the country. Without a crystallized data protection architecture in the country, monetizing the data is itself a very tremendous task and riskful act done by the government. And one needs to question about the fundamental premise of the data collection and rather the data taxation by the government. See, we need to know about the difference between the data data taxation, difference between the data taxation and original taxation by the government, because everything in normal revenue we give the tax to the government directly and indirectly. Similarly, data taxation can also be done in so many ways. See, we'll see about what is data taxation means. Data taxation, like taxation, data taxation, data collection or data taxation is important for the state to perform its functions, essentially like basic demographic details and issuing a driving license, the details of such in indirect way and direct way by collecting the census revenue, so on. Unlike the revenue data, revenue collected as a tax, data collected by the government can be a double spent, that is, it can be used by either by government, that is, it can be used either by government or otherwise it can be given to the private firms for giving us of some money or illegally misused. So it is important to evaluate how the data tax is governed along with the host of related issues such as the optimal level of data taxation, that is data collected, and how the collected data is used without the misuse of the data. What should be the redistributed and broadly the transparency and accountability concerns come with it. So let us try to draw the parallels between the data and data taxation systems to understand the issues of surrounding the data collections. So basically, what are digital identifiers? See, while we collect a tax, there is some identification number personal to our individual of money income. So suppose example, we say that personal account number in bank systems, the PAN number, we say, so that is used as an identifier for revenue, that is called revenue identifier. And because these track the person's income details wherever he goes or wherever he transaction has been happened. Similar to this revenue identifier, we have a digital identifiers. Digital identifiers are mandated by law across the digital platforms for service delivery. These include mobile numbers, device IDs, device IDs, digital IDs, social media account identifiers, and so on. But the very problem is cross-linking of everything. These identifiers is a big problem. As in Puttaswamy judgment, Supreme Court held that the forced cross-linking, such as Aadhaar mobile linkage, is subsequently struck down by Supreme Court. So amounts to the data taxation that forces an individual organization to mandatorily give away the data to private entities under the pretext of the law, when actually no such system exists. So digital identifiers basically deals with the tracking of the person's digital activity or digital transactions. And what is the data taxation system? See, similar to revenue taxation, is it both direct and indirect taxes, both direct as well as indirect taxes. Data taxation systems is also done in two ways, direct as well as indirect. So what are the direct ways of doing it? Such as, see, the government directly collects the various kinds of data because of be it an income details of income or socio-economic data for welfare schemes and health data and for maternal health parameters for providing maternal and child care, etc. Data can also be collected from the various indirect sources also, such as GST. Every transaction you do in the or buy or give in terms of GST, it is noted in terms of history in the Ministry of Corporate Affairs or Ministry of Corporate Affairs look into the GST tax collections, and these history transaction data, among others, such as data is routed to the financial intelligence units, which in executive agency for the prevention of money laundering activities. Therefore, unlike monetary tax, in data tax, digital identifiers can be used as a common foreign key to cross-link and share the data between the various government and private entities, and an emerging cumulative data can be used by multiple parties. Let us see an example of this, as per the law, caste information can be collected by Aadhaar, as it is largely a system to bring together the biometrics information and basic identification details of an individual, but it does not reveal anything about the person's socio-economic status. On the other hand, we see that National Population Register, similar to like Aadhaar, has also been collecting the information of an individual's caste. But once an Aadhaar came into existence, the National Population Register has been collecting both the caste details as well as Aadhaar details. And the information is stored in the state residential data hubs. What are the state residential data hubs? We see that during the enrollment process, the person is data is collected at the stage of enrollment, and this is state register. At each and every state, the data is collected, and it is being transferred as in double layer entities, that is identification details and other caste details, etc. Because the other should not be linked with the caste details directly. So this has been separated. Such is this data has been given to the personal identification details has been given to the UIDAI, that is Aadhaar, and other details such as caste, residence, and also the other socio-economic details has been given to the SRDH, that is State Registered Data Hub, State Residential Data Hub, SRDH. It is given to that. These form the government databases. So, when a caste certificate is issued, it is issued via a digital locker, which is operated by Ministry of Electronics and IT. And the background, the caste certificates are linked with the Aadhaar. In the background, the caste certificates are linked with the Aadhaar. Well, Unique Identification Authority of India clearly stipulates that Aadhaar strictly remains for basic identification of individual, and it does not capture information regarding the socio-economic status of the individual. This cross-linkage of data is in violation of existing laws and also amounts to profiling of a person. See, it says that the caste certificate is linked with backlinked with Aadhaar. It is a violation because that is a cross-linkage of data is in violation of existing laws and also amounts to profiling of a person. Every digital platform built and promoted by the government has inherently been a data taxation network because like private entities, there is no purpose limitation that the data collected. There is no limit on the data collected by even by the government. So when the data is unified or merged with the digital identifiers, a complete data footprint can be accessed.